How Vince McMahon helped Trump win the election. So I'm going to break down all the reasons that I believe that Vince McMahon helped Donald Trump win the election. First of all, let's talk about Trump's connection to Vince McMahon. They have been doing business for many years. Besides Trump's appearance on WWE, it is known that Vince McMahon and the WWE either or donated millions to Trump's foundation, as seen in the Forbes article. Trump took the model of WWE to mobilize Middle America and the South with his rallies. If you compare Trump's rallies to a WWE speech, for example, and even to his own speech on the WWE, they are shockingly similar. Trump took this model, such as the model of Stone Cold's lunacy period of speeches, where even if Stone Cold was talking crazy, it amused and thrilled his fans. That and the white cultural identity that Stone Cold Steve Austin represented proved to be a winning strategy to mobilize the South and the rest of Middle America. Soon enough, Trump took this strategy for his own and started a tour of non-stop, never-ending rallies, just like the non-stop WWE tours across America. The key, in my opinion, was to hit all the cities in America and build a base that identifies with the white cultural identity that Trump claims to represent. And in this, so Trump developed a brand, just as wrestlers developed a brand in the WWE as well. From Stone Cold's to John Cena to The Rock, they have long dramatic speeches with a bunch of taglines and slogans that the audience could repeat and chant. This is a key model that has led to the fanaticism of Trump. This, of course, is credited to none other than Vince McMahon, who, in my opinion, built the blueprint of how to develop a successful American culture brand. McMahon was smart, just as the Republicans are, to target a culture and to eventually sell the brand as a strong identity to Middle America, to the rural South, and so on. In return, Vince McMahon was able to get a multi-million dollar deal never before seen with countries like Saudi Arabia, where WWE is now staging big events. No coincidence this happened after Trump's presidency, and now Trump eerily defends Saudi Arabia after they killed an American journalist in Turkey. To me, this is no coincidence that this happened right around the corner of another lucrative WWE Saudi Arabia event. And it won't stop there. I suspect strongly that there are other deals in the making. I mean, besides the fact that Trump already appointed Vince's wife to a high position in politics, for one, there are other convenient unraveling business deals. Take, for example, Trump's war on the NFL not too long ago. He waged war against the players that kneeled and trashed NFL management for not firing players and such. This leading, of course, to threats of boycott from many Trump voters. Obviously, this could lead to lack of viewership of the NFL. To me, I think there's no real coincidence here. It seems to be all connected to Vince's efforts to revive his XFL football league. This intense attempt to cause a sort of falling apart in the NFL all conveniently happens around the time the Vince McMahon announces he wants to start his pipe dream XFL football league again. Because of all these connections, I believe that it is clear that Vince McMahon is one of the less credited forces that truly helped Trump win the 2016 election.